Good morning. Here is today's word of blessings for you. 1 Thessalonians 5:1-6. Now, brothers and sisters, about times and dates we do not need to write to you, for you know very well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night. While people are saying, peace and safety, destruction will come on them suddenly, as labor pains on a pregnant woman, and they will not escape. But you, brothers and sisters, are not in darkness so that this day should surprise you like a thief. You are all children of the light and children of the day. We do not belong to the night or to the darkness. So then, let us not be like others, who are asleep, but let us be awake and sober. Today's title is You Are the Children of the Light. Our life has many mysteries. There are so many things that are still unknown to us. One of those unknown things are the times and dates of the Lord's return. We are assured that the Lord will return. The Lord Jesus himself said that he will return to us. Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. My Father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, would I have told you that I am going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me so that you also may be where I am. You know the way to the place where I am going. John 14:1-4. The angels who appeared when the Lord was ascended after resurrection assured us of the Lord's return. They were looking intently up into the sky as he was going when suddenly two men dressed in white stood beside them. Men of Galilee, they said, why do you stand here looking into the sky? This same Jesus, who has been taken from you into heaven, will come back in the same way you have seen him go into heaven. Acts 1:10-11. Yet we do not know the exact dates and times of his return. That's intentionally unknown to us, so no one should bother to know it. All the claims that they know the dates and times of the Lord's return turned out to be false so far. The ungodly people will have to face the returning Lord unprepared. But the true believers who love the Lord and wait eagerly for his return will not be so completely unnoticed and unprepared. The Lord clearly showed the signs of his return through his words. We can diligently watch for the signs. At the same time, we can also keep ourselves spiritually awake in prayer and in daily devotions. Then, we will not miss the critical moment of the Lord's return. We are assured of such a spiritual privilege if only we live as children of the light day by day. So, are you living as children of light, shining your light upon the darkness of the world? That's what matters most.